My dear children, today in this module, we are going to study the term resource. Generally, an ordinary person understands by the term reserve that something has been kept apart for emergency. From accounting point of view, reserve means the part of profit retained for any known or unknown contingency, liability, or decrease in the value of asset. American Institute of Certified Public Accountants has been defined reserves as the use of the term reserve be limited to indicate that an undivided part of the asset is being held or retained for general or specific reserves. Any sum which is appropriated out of the profit and loss appropriation account and is not meant to cover up the liability, contingency, commitment, or reduction in the value of asset is a reserve. Reserves is the appropriation of profit. It is created out of the undistributed profit. General reserve is also known as free reserve or revenue reserve. It is created to meet unforeseen future uncertainties. The general reserve is maintained to meet unknown liability or contingency or commitment. General reserve is a source of internal financing. It is the retained profit and technically known as plowing back of profit. Reserves are the appropriation of profits to strengthen the financial position of a business. It is not a charge against the profit, it is the appropriation of profit. Reserves can be used for meeting a future contingency and it helps to strengthening the general financial position of the business. Then redeeming a long-term liability like debentures is a type of reserve. Various examples of reserves are general reserve, workmen compensation fund, investment fluctuation fund, capital reserve, dividend equalization reserve, and reserve for redemption of debentures. These are the important examples of reserves. Now we are going to study the important types of reserves. My dear children, the important types of reserves are general reserve, specific reserve, revenue reserve, and capital reserve. General reserve is the portion of profit which is retained for the improvement of overall financial status of an enterprise and it helps to improve its health in general. The creation and maintenance of general reserve helps in realizing certain well-recognized purpose, especially from the viewpoint of financial management. In other words, the reserve which is not created for any specific purpose is known as general reserve. For example, reserve, general reserve, reserve fund, and contingency reserves. These are the various examples of general reserve. Then next we are going to study the various importance of creating or maintaining general reserve. The first one is improvement of the general financial position of the business by conserving resources is very possible. Then by creating general reserve, arrangement for meeting unforeseen and abnormal losses irrespective of their nature. Then another point is, next we are going to study the important term of general reserve. When the purpose for which the reserve is created is not specified, it is called general reserve. It is also termed as free reserve. Second important type of reserve is specific reserve. Specific reserve is created for some specific purpose and can be utilized only for that purpose. Example, dividend equalization reserve, workmen compensation reserve, investment fluctuation fund, and debenture redemption reserve. Dividend equalization reserve is created to stabilize or maintain dividend rate. Workmen compensation fund is created to provide the claims of the workers due to accidents. Investment fluctuation fund is created to provide the claims of workers due to accident. And the last one is debenture redemption reserve. It is created to provide the funds for redemption of debentures. These reserves, which is created for specific purpose and it cannot be used for any other purposes except for which is created. The various examples are dividend equalization reserve, debenture redemption reserve, investment fluctuation reserve, etc. Next is revenue receipts. Revenue receipts are created out of the revenue profits, which are usually distributable profits. In other words, it is the profit which has been withheld from paying dividend out of the total distributable profits. Revenue reserves are created from the revenue profits which arises out of the normal operating activities of the business. The various examples are general reserve, workmen compensation fund, debenture redemption reserve, retained earnings, dividend equalization. Next is capital reserve. Capital reserve is a gain which arises either on sale of long-term asset or in the settlement of liabilities. The transaction is of capital nature. Then capital reserve acts as an accounting mechanism for conserving profits. It imparts an element of stability to the overall finance of the business enterprise. Allocation of revenue reserve may be made to the capital reserve due to legal obligations. Capital reserve does not include any free balance which might be used for distribution of profits. Some examples of capital reserves are issue of shares at premium, premium on issue shares of or debentures, profit on sale of fixed assets, profit on redemption of debentures, creation of capital redemption reserve upon the redemption of preference shares, profit prior to incorporation, balance of forfeited shares account, profit on redemption of debentures, profit accruing on sale of fixed assets, etc. Capital reserves, general reserve, revenue reserve and specific reserve. These are the important types of reserves. Thank you.